We don't see what's there, whatever it is. We don't see what's there in front of us. We see what we think is there. Whatever you say you saw is what you think you saw. Now, sometimes you saw correctly, but sometimes you don't. So if you're arguing about what you think you saw, be careful, because you might have saw wrong. And I love this quote. That's at the bottom of that first page, page number 3. So the bottom line is, and the book says it, every time you face a situation, every time you face a situation and you're faced with information, what you perceive is dependent as much upon your perspective as it is upon external reality. So what you perceive to be there is just as important as what's actually there. Does that make sense? This is how powerful your perceptions are. What you perceive to be there, how you think, how you organize information, what you take in, what you don't, that's as important as what's actually in front of you. Because what are you going to argue about? What was there or what you think was there? You're going to argue about what you think was there. And they're going to argue with you as well. And you're going to have an argument, not about what was actually there, but what you both think was there. So be very careful with your perceptions. Always be willing to step back and say, well, maybe I missed something. Maybe I saw that wrong. Maybe I can take another look at that, or five other looks at that, or however many it takes to see those extra words. It turns out that reality as we see it is a movie generated by our brains. And that's what it is. How many realities exist? Really? One for you, and one for her, and one for him, and one for him, and one for me. So really, reality is subjective to your experience. And that's why if we argue about reality, we're going to be arguing about two different things. The best you can do is understand someone else's reality. And you possibly can share it. But to say there's only one reality, and that one reality is yours, and that's the only one, you're done. You're done. Because guess what? There's 7-point-something other billion people thinking the same exact thing. So to understand, yes, your reality is your reality, but your reality is not the reality. Does that make sense? All right. That's a very, very important concept. And that's why the name of this chapter is a reality check. If we want to understand how to change things and change our behavior and understand things differently, if we want to make changes, you first have to understand where you are right now. What is your reality right now? If you want to change things in your reality in your life, you have to know where you are and why you're where you are right now. So it's a reality check. Why do you have the reality you have? Why do you see the things you see the way you see them? And what are they? So that's why it's called a reality check.